Now we're going to talk about this concept of object-oriented programming. This is a concept that gives a lot of people who are learning how to program a lot of trouble, and I don't think it needs to. I think the biggest problem with object-oriented programming in explaining it to those who haven't used it before and who are new to programming. In fact, I was just listening to this great speech by a great man, and he was talking about in education, a lot of times we are filled with facts without understanding how those facts are going to help us solve a problem. And if there's no end goal to be attached to the facts, then it becomes a very tedious process to try and force ourselves on faith to think, I'm going to use this. This is going to be important to me at some point. And so I thought maybe what I'd do first when we talk about object-oriented programming is to talk about what problems it solves. And so to do that, I thought about creating a little example. I like to play the game Monopoly. I've always liked it. And Monopoly is one of those funny games because I feel like I'm the only one who likes to play it. It's hard to play with anybody because you can't find somebody to sit down with you for a few hours and play a game of Monopoly. But it's a pretty entertaining game for me. I like it. In the game Monopoly, in many games, we roll a die. And I've actually just bought the game on a couple of different devices, actually, so I can play it with the computer, because the computer doesn't mind playing with me. This is like, it reminds me of my dating life back in, like high school. The computer didn't mind dating me, just real people. So, anyway, I'm going to create this game, public class, and this is going to be, just a game. I'll call it Monopoly. It's not going to be anything like that. Can I do this? Is this legal? Am I using some, violating some copyright standard somewhere? So, oh no, this isn't that game Monopoly. This is another game about a monopoly. How about that? Public static void main string args. And in this game, the very first thing I'm going to need to do is roll a die, right? And in fact, in Monopoly, you roll two dice. And so I'm going to create integers for die one. It's always weird that they call it die in my mind, too. And die two, which was a great movie series, by the way. The die one and die two movies, those were excellent. In order to be able to create a random number to simulate the roll of those die, I'm going to need to import the java.util.random class. And then in order to roll these die, I need to get a random number out of 6, right? So I can say, I guess I need to have the, let's see, how do I want to do this? Probably I'll create a total variable and set it equal to 0. And then I want to get the total of those two die. So I'll set die 1 equal to, I guess I need to create my random number. Random r equals new random. That's our random number generator. And so I'm going to set die 1 equal to r.nextInt out of how many? Well, a die has 6 sides. And then I want it to be a 1 through a 6 rather than a 0 through a 5, so I'm going to add 1 to that. Okay, we've done this before. Hopefully nothing new. And then for the die 2, I'm going to do the exact same thing. Out of 6, add 1 to it, and then I can have the user go that amount by saying, let's set the total equal to die 1 plus die 2. Okay, and then we get the total, and then I can say the total roll was, and then concatenate on the total. Save this. And then let's try running it and see what happens. Okay, so in this case, whoa, snake eyes, first roll. Nice work. Okay, total roll was 11. Total roll was 3. I should be getting between 2 and 12, right? That's the options we have when we roll 2 die. So I'm seeing that I'm getting random numbers. None are greater than 12. None are greater than, there's a 12 there. None are less than 2 that I've seen. And so this looks like it seems to be functioning pretty good. Well, if instead of Monopoly this was some other game and I'm just trying to get to see if the die total was a certain amount, like in the game of Craps, which I've never really understood that name, and I've never actually played the game, but there's something about rolling a 7 and 11, is that right? This is some high quality stuff you've signed on for. So I can make a decision now. I could take that roll and I could make a decision based on the roll. So I could decide whether they win. And I could say if the total of that roll was a 7 or total was an 11, System.out.println, you win, included in quotes. Okay, so we've now made a decision based on the number that was rolled, and we've got a little game that's going on here. And I don't know why I keep bringing up stuff I don't know anything about. Why would I bring up Craps? Because I don't know the rules. I don't know what you win if you win. I don't know what do you double your bet? Do you... and so I probably ought to look up those rules. But anyway, I'm making up my own game here. So if the total is a 7 or 11, you win. And then, well, that's good enough for now. So let's try this game and see if it works. Oh, wow. First roll was a 7, and I win. I won again. That was a 6. 11. Wait, I won. Man, I like this game. So I'm doing this a bunch of times, and there was another 7, so I win. On the times I have a 7 or 11, that's a win. Other times it doesn't print anything. I probably ought to have maybe an else here that says, if it wasn't a 7 or 11, you lose. Okay, so now I'll have an outcome one way or the other. I got an 11 again. I win. Total was 11. I won again. I rolled 2 11s in a row. Did you see that? This is amazing. There's a 6 and I lose. 8 and I lose. 8 and I lose. 3 and I lose. There was a 5 and I lose. And what would be kind of fun is to do this for a certain number of rolls. In fact, I'll do that just to add another little element to this game. I'm going to do this for a certain number of rolls. So for an int I, I'll start at 0 and go while I is less than, and then a number of rolls. So let's roll the die 1,000 times. And then, so I'm going to put that's the end of my 4. And then all of this needs to be indented one level inside the 4. So I'm going to do this over and over again for 1,000 times. And I want to keep track of how many times I win and how many times I lose. And so I'll create 2 more variables. One int for wins, or maybe I'll say num wins. I'll start that at 0. Int num losses. Start that one at 0, and then when I win, I can increase, instead of saying you win, what I'll do is increase the number of wins by 1, and then number of losses by 1 if I lose. How about that? Okay, so I've got a pretty simple game here. I'm going to roll this dice 1,000 times, or these dice 1,000 times, And if I win, then I'm going to increment the number of wins. And if I lose, I'm going to increment the number of losses. Once I'm done with the loop, then I'll just print out my results. So I'll say system.out.println wins. And let's see if I'm as lucky as I really think I am. Losses. So I'll print out the number of losses. All right, so we get the idea of this program. Once again, I'm coming in, I create some variables that I'm going to need. I build my random number generator, one for die one, one for die two, one for the total amount, and then an integer to keep track of the number of wins and the number of losses. Then simulate the roll of the dice, and I'm going to do that for 1,000 times. Start an counter I at 0, and while I is less than 1,000, then I'm going to do this over and over and over again. Now, I did less than 1,000 because I started at 0. That's just old habit, because that's the way it is in computers. We always start at 0. But I could start at 1 and say less than or equal to 1,000 if that makes you feel better. So we'll start on roll 1 and go till we're at 1,000. And then each time we're going to get a random number for each of the die, total up the amount, and then print out the result. That'll be a lot of printing out, but it won't hurt anything. And then if the number is 7 or 11, then I'm going to increase the number of wins, else I'm going to increase the number of losses. The hardcore gamblers that are listening to this program, of course, if you're the hardcore gambler, maybe you've won so much money you don't even care about programming. But for the rest of us, any gamblers in here are going to be bugged that I'm totally destroying these rules, but that's my rules of this game. Okay, so let's try this. I'll run it. Okay, so out of the amount, I won 224 times, and I lost 776 times. Let's see how this percentage holds up. 218, 272. Well, let's do a big number. Let's do like a million rolls and see what happens. This is going to take a while just because I'm printing out every time. I might be here all night. Okay, I really need to take that printing off. This would actually go very fast if I wasn't printing the results. Let me end this and comment out that line. All right, let's try this again. Okay, so 222,000 wins, 778,000 losses, and that's pretty much the same amount we saw last time, or the same ratio. There we go, 220,000. So that's basically the ratio, and I'm sure we could get in and figure out the odds and why we're getting that actual number. Well, let's try a number like 10 and see what happens out of 10 rolls, what happens. Well, still fell into the same ratio. Two wins, two eight losses. And so I can run this a bunch of times, but we're falling, you know, right around that same number. Anyway, so this is a program that we could write. It's not Monopoly. It's something else. But it basically is a little dice simulation program. And so what I'm going to do is take this program then and talk about why we might want to build it in an object-oriented manner, and I'll do that in the next discussion. Spencer out.